Hi everyone, welcome to this week's Halton Hills housing update. So the numbers this week are pretty bananas. I wanted to think maybe we'd be in a changing market by now, but absolutely not. We might be in the worst market we've seen this year. The inventory isn't as low, but there's a lot going on. So let's look at the numbers. In Georgetown this week, we had 17 properties sell. Nothing crazy about that number, but let's just look at the other numbers I'm about to say. So 15 of them sold over asking. 9 of them got $100,000 plus over asking. And there was one that did get over $250,000 over asking. So we're seeing a little bit less of the like $200,000 to $400,000 over asking, but I think that's because price points have really gone up since where we were in like March when they took that huge jump. But these are some really huge numbers we're seeing right now. And basically everyone is getting multiple offers if you have a house on the market. So yeah, it's crazy. Looking at new listings, we only had 12 new listings. So that is a gap from the 17 sales, which you can guess means our inventory is going to be down. This is crazy. It's not like I shouldn't be surprised, but I am surprised. Like, how is inventory like never gonna go up? It's gonna change at some point, but like, honestly, it should be seeing a little bit of an increase right now, and we just aren't. So in Acton this week, 3 properties sold, 3 of them got over asking. Story's the same in Acton, one got 150,000 plus. There were 4 new listings there. So I guess some stuff hitting the market, but still very low numbers. Glenn Williams had 1 sale, it got 100 plus thousand over asking, and there was 1 new listing there, which was the house that got 100 plus thousand over asking. Limehouse saw 1 sale and 1 new listing, and the rural market saw 3 sales, which is a good number for rural. This goes back to the theory of when there's nothing to buy in town, we see our rural spike, so that number supporting that, because 3 sales in 1 week is a lot for the rural market, and there was 5 new listings there. Okay, so now looking at active inventory. Last week we were at 56, this week we are down to 53 active listings. So we were in the 40s a few weeks ago, but honestly, it feels like there's more buyers here right now, and that number is really struggling and could be dropping again. So Georgetown, we had 26 active listings last week. It is down to 21 active listings this week. 21 is an extremely low number for all of Georgetown. Looking at under 700,000, we remain the same at 2 active listings. Those will likely both be gone yesterday or today. 700,000 to 800,000 is down to only 2 active listings. 800 to 1 million took a bit of a jump, a little bit, to 5 active listings. And the million plus price point, again, this price point is, it's been the bananas price point all year. We were at 17 last week. We dropped to 12 active listings this week in that price point. That stuff cannot stay on the market right now. So overall, Georgetown is in a real spot here. The buyers are out and these numbers are not leading us in any kind of direction for relief for buyers. So Acton this week is up to 6 active listings. That is a super low number, but it's up from last week, so there's that. Glenn Williams is down to 2 active listings from 3, and Limehouse remains the same at 3 active listings, and the rural market is up slightly to 21 active listings. If our town inventory is struggling, our rural market is gonna start to feel a pinch. I mean, looking at the rural stuff, we have 1 at 1.1 and then it jumps right up to 1.6, but there are just so many buyers in town, like under 2 million. I can't get over this. So for sellers, this is very good news. If you can get your property on the market, these numbers are in your favor. The fact, I think 15 of 17 has to be probably one of our highest ratios in terms of in Georgetown properties. And sorry, I talk about Georgetown all the time, but it's really our main big market and it indicates sort of what's happening in the other markets. But 15 of 17 properties getting over asking, and again, 9 of those 100 plus thousand, like We're in a real situation here. And so if you have the ability to get your home on the market and you're in a position to move to a cottage, move north, like do something, consider doing that because, again, no market stays around forever. So this time last year, we thought we were selling at the peak. People thought they were buying at the peaks and we've gone up so much. So now I really think we are going to stay strong through to next spring, but at some point, something is going to have to stabilize and we are going to have to things are just going to have to calm down a bit. But for now, there's absolutely no calming in this market. We are no better off than we were a month ago. I'll be back next Tuesday with September's numbers, which are going to be crazy. We'll see you then.